Middle School, The Worst Years of My Life, Chapter 23, Operation Wraith. Rules broken, 23, rules to go, 89 points, 340,000, 2 lives remaining. So what do I get anyway, I said. Leo and I were hanging out in my room, counting up everything I'd done so far. Get? He asked me. For all these points, they've got to be worth something, right? What do I win? I said. Depends on how many points you finish with, Leo said. You need at least 1 million. For what? I said. He thought about it for a second. A week of base jumping at the Grand Canyon, all expenses paid. I'll need training, I said. No problem, we'll get you the best. I like the sound of this, for starters anyway. Then whitewater rafting, I said, all the way down to Colorado. And rock climbing, back out of the canyon, Leo said, where your Lexus 4x4 and a fake driver's license are waiting for you. Sweet. The whole time Leo was drawing, while we talked. Nothing new there. He's always drawing. What about Jeannie Galetta? I said, put her in too. That's going to be another 200,000 points, Leo said. But I'll throw in Bear, you know, so he can get lost in the wild and adopted by real bears. This was getting better and better. In that case, let him get eaten by real bears. But Leo shook his head. Nobody gets hurt, remember? It's already in the rule book. I'll make an exception, I told him.
I'm just going to flick that picture up for you guys.
I'll make an exception, I told him. No exceptions, Leo said. Besides, you need that no hurt rule. It's the only part of all this that Jeannie Galetta will like. This is why Leo's a genius. He thinks of everything. You know, I said, you ought to try talking to other people once in a while. They'd like you if you did. But he didn't answer. Leo the Silent was silent. And that's when I realized someone was outside my door. Rafe, are you in there? It was Mum. Just a second, I yelled. Leo did his disappearing act, and I threw my notebook into my drawer just as Mum opened the door anyway. One look at her face and I could tell I was in big trouble. No, not in a second, Mum said. We need to talk right now. Chapter 24. I'll take the dragon lady over the bear any day.
And there's Leo broken up by a hammer.
When I came into the living room, Mum was standing there, looking mad, just like I expected. But Bear was there too, awake and sitting up, not expected. What's up? I said, playing it cool for now. Did you have detention today? Mum said. Uh-oh, busted. Well, kind of, I said. Kind of, Bear said. Kind of? What does that mean? Mum asked him to stay calm, but she kept her eyes on me. I got a call from Mrs. Stryker. She says she left a message here last week. Do you know anything about that? Oh man, double busted. Just then, Georgie came wandering in, of course. What's going on? Is Rafe in trouble? She said. Go to your room, Bear yelled at her. Don't talk to her that way, Mum said. Georgia, honey, this is between Rafe and us. Go on now. Georgia disappeared again, but I knew she was just standing in the hall listening, where we couldn't see her. At least I'd have witnesses if Bear killed me, which he looked like he wanted to. You're grounded for a week, he said, standing over me. And no more touching the answering machine. You got that? Hang on a minute, Mum said. I want to hear Rafe's side of this. Carl, sit down, please. Bear sat and Mum looked at me again. Rafe, talk. Unfortunately, my side of the story wasn't worth much. I told them all about the scooter in gym class and detention and how I'd erased the message on the machine. Even without saying a word about Operation Rafe, I'd still been just as bad as Bear, just as bad as Bear thought I was. When I was done, Mum took a deep breath. Rafe, I'm going to ask you something else now, and I want an honest answer, she said. Does Leo have anything to do with this? I probably would have told her the truth, but Bear decided what he thought about it before I could even open my mouth. Again with the Leo thing, he yelled at me. I've had it up to here with that. I don't want to ever hear that name Leo in my house again. You understand? You freak. You're the freak, I shouted back. That's enough, both of you, Mum said, standing between us. Rafe, you're grounded until further notice. Carl, you go off somewhere. I don't want to talk to either one of you right now. I was already headed back to my room anyway. Our little talk was over. I found Georgia in the hall, no surprise, but I didn't bust her. I just pushed her back towards her own room and then slammed my door behind me as hard as I could. I wanted to throw something, hit something, and exterminate Bear all at the same time. You know, there are ways of getting back at him, Leo said. You shut up, I told him. You're not even real. I picked up this old ceramic turtle I'd made in second grade and threw it against the wall. It smashed into a million pieces, but I didn't care. I didn't even care about being grounded. It's not like I had 24 friends waiting to do stuff with me after school every day. In fact, I had only one friend, and technically, he didn't even exist. I'm just saying, Leo told me. I know a way you could get revenge on Bear, and maybe even earn some points at the same time, if you're interested. It took me a while to calm down, but once I thought about it, I realized I definitely was interested. Just so you know, this one could really get you into trouble, Leo said. Who cares? I told him. I'm already in trouble. Keep talking. Chapter 25, Time Out. Okay, time out for a second. I just want to say it. It's not like I was trying to hide from Leo. I just want to say, it's not like I was trying to hide Leo from you, or at least the part about his not exactly being real. I know. What kind of 12-year-old still has imaginary friends? But I don't really think of him that way. It's just that he's always been around, and there's never been a reason to stop talking to him. Maybe I'm not doing too good a job at explaining this. It's not like I think Leo's really there. It's more like, what if someone was there, talking back, and helping me figure out stuff? Someone who's always on my side, you know? Like I said before, I'm not exactly popular, so I'll take my help where I can get it. If that makes me weird or whatever, I guess I can live with that. I hope you can too. For what it's worth, I've told you way more than I've ever told anyone else. Except Leo, of course. You know, about Operation Rafe and my stupid point reward system. You know about my problems with my future stepfather. And most embarrassing of all, you know about my impossible and very ridiculous crush on Jeannie Galetta. Here's one more secret, just so you know we're friends. Jeannie Galetta is not going to be my girlfriend at the end of this story. I'm not saying that because I don't have confidence or something. I'm saying it because it's my book and I know how it all turns out. So if you're the type who likes the romantic stuff and you're waiting around for her to start liking me like that, I'm just saying, don't hold your breath. Okay? Now you know all this stuff about me, and I still don't know anything about you. I don't even know if you're still there. Are you? And if you are, can I trust you with the rest? I still want to know, are you a good person? Maybe it's not fair of me to ask, since I haven't even figured out whether I'm a good person or not. I guess you can be the judge. Here's the deal. If you're okay with me so far, then keep reading. But if you've gotten this far and you still think I'm the lowest of the low, and I don't deserve to have my own book, then maybe you should stop right now, because it only gets worse from here. Or better, depending on how you look at it. Signed, your friend, RK. We're going to come back with chapter 26 soon.